Hi, my name is Manuel Alekhani. I am the Dean and Professor of CTOR Academy, and I'd like to welcome you to another session of CTOR Channel. The topic of today's discussion is coupled to force ratio. If you remember from the previous discussion, we talked about how we can produce different type of tooth movement by just changing the point of application of the force without changing the magnitude or direction of the force. But why was that? And we discussed that because the distance between the force and center of resistance would change, and that would produce different magnitude of the moment. Therefore, if I want to produce different type of tooth movement without changing the point of application of the force, we conclude that we need to change the magnitude of the moment. But how we can change the magnitude of the moment while we are keeping one point of application? It seems that we need to produce a moment in opposite direction, and by playing with the magnitude of that moment in opposite direction, we should be able to produce different type of tooth movement without changing the point of application. This is important because majority of the time in clinical scenarios, we don't have access to, for example, the apex or the center of resistance of the tooth. And if you want to produce those type of tooth movement, we should be able to just apply the force at the level of the crown and create those movements. This brought us to a concept called couple to force ratio. Based on that concept, we know that the couple can produce a moment. Force, on the other hand, has its own side effect moments. And if we play with the magnitude of the couple properly, without changing the point of application of the force, we should be able to control the moment that the force produces and create different type of tooth movement. Let's look at different examples. Assume we apply a force of F, that is with the distance D from the center of resistance. So if I say what is the equivalent system of my force system, you will say there would be a force at the level of center of resistance, and there would be a moment in the system that will have the tendency to rotate the tooth. So what would be the movement? You will say the force will have the displacement capability to move the tooth along the line of action. And the moment part has the rotation tendency. And if you superimpose these two movements together, it will look like under control tipping, where the center of rotation is between the apex and center of resistance. Apex goes one direction and crown goes in another direction. If I tell you how much was the magnitude of the couple that you applied here? Remember, I'm not talking about the magnitude of the moment of the force. In addition to your force, did you apply any couple? That's the question. Well, you will say, well, I did not apply any other couple. I just put my force at the level of the bracket, at the level of incisal edge, and that was caused uncontrolled tipping. So we can say the magnitude of the couple in the system was zero. And if I say what is the ratio between the amount of the couple and the force, we will say zero divided by the force, whatever magnitude of force you have. And we know that mathematically that means the couple to force ratio is equal to zero. Remember, we are not talking about the moment that force produces here. We are talking about the couple that we produce. But how we can produce a couple in the system so we can change this amount of the couple force ratio on the system? Because we are looking at the third order view, the best way to create a couple in the third order view is to use a rectangular wire with the brackets, for example, and rotate the rectangular wire inside the bracket that produces a couple. If you want to change the type of tooth movement, I said that the direction of the couple should be always different from the direction of the moment of the force. So if moment of the force in this example is counterclockwise, the direction of the couple should be clockwise. So assume I'm rotating the rectangular wire, I'm putting it inside the bracket, and that's produce a couple in the corner of the brackets and produce a clockwise moment for me. So let's look at the example. I'm applying a force at the level of the bracket, but at the same time I'm rotating my wire, the rectangular wire, so it produces a couple in opposite direction. And I rotated enough that the amount of the couple that produced by my rectangular wire, the moment resultant of this couple is equal to the moment that produced by the force. So I have a couple and I have a force. What would be the equivalent system of this system? You will say you draw the force at the level of center of resistance and the moment that the force produced, MAF, and you draw the moment that the carbon produce, MSC. And MAF and MC are equal to each other. Therefore, they cancel each other. The only things that the system received would be the force. The result of this one would be a translational movement. There is no rotation in the system. Even though we are changing the translation and rotation in all of our examples, I don't want you to get confused that these two phenomena occur separately. They occur simultaneously, but for simplicity, we separated two in our examples. What was the couple to force ratio in this system? You can say the amount of the couple that we applied was equal to the amount of the moment that force produced, but in the opposite direction. What was the magnitude of the moment of the force? Was equal to the force times the distance between the force and center of resistance. So let's, instead of using MC divided by F, use the equal magnitude of it, that is F times D divided by F. So we say anytime that the ratio between the amount of the couple in our system and force is equal to the distance between the force and center of resistance, in that system we can produce translation, pure translation without any rotation. Let's look at another example. What happens if the amount of the magnitude of the moment that couple produce is less than the amount of the moment that the force produce? Again, we apply a couple, but a little bit less, and we apply a force, same magnitude, and what would be an equivalent system? We transfer the force to the center of resistance, we draw the moment of the force, has not been changed from the previous example, but the amount of the moment of the couple is a little bit less. So what would be the moment resultant in the system? The moment of the couple will reduce the amount of the moment of the force. So the remaining moment in the system has the same direction and moment of the force, means counterclockwise, and we have also the force. So if I draw the movement that we have, the force will cause translation, while the moment of the force, the remaining, cause a little bit rotation. Now, if you're superimposing the initial and final position, it seems that the apex did not move. However, the crown move, something close to the control tipping. So if I say how we can produce control tipping using proper couple and force ratio, you will say the amount of the couple that we are producing should be less than the amount of the moment of the force. Because moment of the force is F times D, the amount of the moment of the couple should be less than F times D. And if you are making the ratio, therefore the ratio would be less than the D, less than the distance between the force and center of resistance. You can see by changing the ratio between the couple to force from 0 to D, we can produce different type of tooth movement. What would happen if I apply a larger couple in the system? In that case, the moment that couple produces is more than the moment that force produces. Let's draw that in the equivalent system. In our equivalent system, force will be transferred to the center of resistance. Moment of the force is the same. However, magnitude of the moment that produced by couple is in opposite direction and is much bigger. Now, if you draw the resultant moments, it would be a small moment left in the system clockwise. Now, if you draw the movement, force produced exactly the same amount of displacement. However, the moment in the system will rotate the tooth, so if you superimpose the initial and final, it seems that the crown did not move. However, the apex of the tooth has moved, root movement. So during the root movement, we can say the couple to force ratio, the magnitude of the couple in the system is bigger than the magnitude of the moment of the force in the system. Therefore, this ratio is bigger than D. What happened? We just apply a couple and there is no force. In that case, you have pure rotation, means that the center of resistance does not move, because in the equivalent system of this system, there is only one moment in the system, and that's the moment that produced by the couple. There is no force, there is no moment of the force. And if I ask you what is the couple to force ratio in this system, you will say the amount of the couple in the system is what we are producing, but the amount of the force is zero. The moment of the force is zero, therefore the couple to force ratio is any numbers that is moment of the couple is divided by zero, then that's become infinity mathematically. So when the amount of the force in the system is zero and we have just couple, we have pure rotation. Now if you put all these things in one slide, you can see as we are changing the magnitude of the couple in compared with the force, We can modify the magnitude of the moment that appears in the system. We can control the rotation that is the resultant of the force somehow and make different type of tooth movement. I hope you enjoyed another session of CTOR channel. The next session, we will continue the discussion on couple of force ratio in different dimensions. Please don't forget to subscribe to our channel, and please don't forget to press the like button to support us. Thank you.